from Kabiya Street 1. So go ahead, Mohammed.
Good evening. I want to thank you for having us here. I'm Mohammed Kabiya, and the Bedouin village is always the name of the village is follow the tribe name. Like my village name, Kabiya, is follow my tribe name, Kabiya. I'm 27 years old, student for political science and Middle East History University of Haifa. I want to begin with who are the Bedouins. The Bedouins, they are a nomadic people that moved from Saudi Arabia and Iraq and the Arab states in the east of Israel, and they arrived to Israel. In Israel, we have 350,000 Bedouins. The bigger part is in the south, in the Negev, 250,000 Bedouins, and in the north, where I'm living, is 100,000 Bedouins. I want to tell you about my personal story, my family personal story with the Jewish people in State of Israel and the Israel land. Do you know who is the left one, the right one in the picture?
Hebrew people.
Is Alexander Zaid. Alexander Zaid, he was the head of the Shomer movement, the first Jewish security movement in land of Israel. And who is on the left is my great grandfather. And what is the connection between the both is that in the 1936, after the first partition plan, Arab insurgents came to kill Alexander Zaid. And my great grandfather was his neighbor and heard about the schemes. Then my great grandfather decided to protect Alexander Zaid and his family. And when his family and his wife and Tzipora and children, Yiftach Giora. And when the insurgents came, my great grandfather attacked the insurgents and keep them live. And for me and for my tribe, for my Bedouin community, it was the first connection and relations created with the Jewish people. And after that, we created alliance, a blood alliance with the Jewish people that cost us 191 Bedouin soldiers that fall in the Israeli battles. I myself sacrificed 3 of my family members in the Israeli battles. And after that, in 1947, the Palmach had many problems and difficulties to get information from the town Tzfat, Safad, and Yigal Alon, who was the head of the Palmach, went to the Sheikh Abu Yusuf from El Heb tribe in the north of Israel and asked them for their help. And the Sheikh sent 2 members of the tribe to Tzfat to get information for the Palmach. The 2 persons they arrested there and killed there. And until nowadays, their families, and nobody knows where is their bodies, because the Syrians, I don't know what they doing with what they did with their bodies. And after that, in 1948, when it set with the displacement, the Bedouins was the first group minority with the Druze. But we before. Was the first minority group that joined in the army. And from these days until nowadays, the Bedouins scouts, they are the soldiers and the combats that opening and closing the Israeli borders. And after that, in 1985, the IDF created another unit, the Desert Trackers unit, Gatzar 585. And they are activating in Gaza Strip all the time. not the not like the other battalions that they moved off moved كل حצי سنه every 6 months because they knows the area and they knows the how to fight in this area and because that they are excellent combatants that doing their jobs well עוד אחד עזוב עוד אחד and I myself I had the pleasure and served in the army in the Israeli Air Force I served in a rescue and help unit squadron and our job was our mission was is to save lives to help people that fallen in emergency situation and many times in the squadron in the my unit in my base heard emergency siren and the pilots and our staff departed we never knew before to where the staff departing we only get the information on the flight and many times we found ourselves the staff found themselves in enemy area and rescue Palestinian people Syrian people I can give you example for one time we had a siren emergency siren and we had to take a Palestinian child from Gaza border to the Israeli hospital to take a medical aid because he had a urgent medical situation another time we helped and it's many time the IDF did it take the Syrian refugees that injured in the civil war in Syria and many times they helping another people that and especially travelers that fall in emergency situation when they doing a trip after amazing 3 years in military service I went to work in the checkpoints authority and every morning I management thousands of people or thousands of Palestinian people to work in Israel and I don't know if you know that at least 80,000 Palestinian enter to Israel every morning to work 80,000 legally and at least 150,000 Palestinian people illegally enter to Israel to work every morning and they staying in Israel and the governments know that but they let them to work and to live in and one day I all the time I ask myself what keep this Palestinian people to enter to work in Israel and one day I asked one of them why is very important to you to enter to work in Israel and he felt very freely to speak with me because we speaking the same language Arabic he told me it's very basically what we get in pay in Israel is much more than what we get in pay in the West Bank and under the Palestinian Authority and we in Israel have rights in the work we don't have it in the Palestinian Authority and in the West Bank if we injured or have a emergency situation the Israeli bosses they give us the help to fix it and we haven't it in the West Bank and I left my work after a few months in the checkpoints authority and went to work to study in University of Haifa in the University of Haifa after the students were Ram studied too as after students they are Arabs Muslims Christian Druze in one day you can see a rally protests in one side students waving the Palestinian flag and you can hear that they support the Palestinian narrative and the other side students that waving the Israeli flag, and they support the Israeli narrative, and you can hear dialogue, and nobody limit them to say what they want. Nobody limit them to say their minds, their opinions. And because we live in a free speech campus and the democracy campus, then nobody limit them. And after that, after 1 hour, you can find the same students study side by side in the classroom. And in the same time, when I began start to study in Haifa University, I started to prepare a Bedouin guys, you can see here, Bedouin guys to the military service. The Bedouins, they are volunteering in the army, not as they're mandatory like the Druze, because the Druze, they signatured with the governments. The Bedouins, no, they're not. But we volunteering every year, hundreds of the Bedouin teenagers, they're joining in the army, in the IDF. And I began to prepare this teenagers to integrate in special units in the Israeli army. And why is very important to prepare them? Because the Israeli society, the Israeli society all the time and always we are under Torah attacks and war situations. They cover the Israeli society to a security society. Then who is dead military service is very easy to them to integrate to the Israeli society after their military service, more than the another people that didn't serve and as a military service or a national service. Because that I did this activation with the Bedouins guys, and I want to finish with a short video that what these guys, these teenagers, doing, and these amazing things.
שירות משמעותי בצבא ההגנה לישראל. הם בונים את דור העתיד של החברה הישראלית. החניכים האלה ביקרו שחלים בבסיסיהם וחלקו להם ממתקים. ביקרו חיילים פצועים בבתי חולים ואמרו להם אנחנו נלך דרככם. והם התעטפו בכחול לבן וצעדו בכפרים לזכר החללים הבדואים אשר חרפו את נפשם למען המדינה. הם תמיד אישותו יד לתושבים בכפרים. הם הזדעזעו ונסערו כששמעו צורת השואה אסתר במחנה הריכוז ביוגוסלביה ואמרו לה והבטיחו לה לעולם לא עוד, אנחנו נתגייס שזה לא יקרה שוב. כל זה עשו הנוער הבדואי, אך הם עדיין זקוקים לדבר קטן. במיוחד בימים האלה שבהם השנאה מנסה להפריד בין כולם ללא הבדל בין גזע ודת ומין. הם זקוקים לחיבוק כמו החיבוק שזה היה שעבר. והם זקוקים לחיבוק של החברה הישראלית, כי אנחנו לא רק שדה הקרב יכולים ללחם יחד כתף אל כתף, אנחנו יכולים לעשות את זה גם באזרחות בחיי יום יום, שפושטים את המדים.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much, Mohammed. So